We just heard how creating psychological safety can empower teams, and it's critical for team members in a crisis to reach out. For example, in a difficult airway, if someone is struggling to maintain ventilation due to muscle fatigue, we need to reach out to those team members and ask them, do you need to switch out? We have someone who can relieve you and alternate with you. Let them know that it's okay to step back and be the first one to say that's okay by offering the help. David, trust is an important part of psychological safety. So what are some of the techniques that you use to relay trust in a crisis?
I think acknowledging a backup plan can be a really good way to convey trust. It takes the pressure off the individual to know that the team can back them up. So if I say, Alex, you're working on this IV line to start the resuscitation, but if you can't get it, let us know, and we'll start an intraosseous line, that might be one example.
That's a great example because Alex now knows that he can trust the team to have his back and the support if he can't complete the task. And he's actually cued to speak up if that's the case.
To follow up on this, we invite you to read an article by Amy Edmondson titled, What Psychological Safety Is Not.